A very warm welcome and a good evening to yet another exciting and informative episode of our technology show, Innovate. You know, for Urban TV, we bring you nothing but the best from the world of technology, both here in Uganda as well as globally. Now, my name is Brenda Kembabazi, but first, a sneak peek of what we have for you on the show this evening.
This week on Innovate, we bring you Twine Julius, Uganda's Albert Einstein or a genius in the making. We also bring you the Zone Web application that is aimed at benefiting youth in their adolescent age by the Ministry of Health. And in Globotech, we bring you a system that is being tested by doctors in Seattle for transporting donor hearts that may help close the gap. We also bring you dogs that could help screen for breast cancer and the Sequence smartwatch that can charge itself using a kinetic battery system.
Meet Uganda's Albert Einstein, or a genius in the making. Now, 26-year-old Julius Twine prides himself in making solar-powered radios and electricity-saving bulbs. But anyway, his journey doesn't come without bumps. He decries low government support as well as the society that he comes from. But for us here at Innovate, what we bring you are the young minds that better the tech we use every single day. Take a look.
Twine Julius dropped out of school at the age of 18 as his family had inadequate income to further his studies when he completed ordinary level secondary school. But who would have known that this would not halt the great dreams in the young man's mind? He's codenamed the Young Innovator, with over 5 prototypes to his name, such as a radio powered by solar energy and an energy-saving bulb. Julius speaks with much pride of his innovations, boasting of their ability to solve Uganda's economic and social problems.
I did some new ideas, like 2010, new system of GAN, 2011, new community radio station, where I used that community radio station in competition, that is district level and national level, plus East Africa, where I was where I acquired the second position and certificates and trophies and so on. But by then I was doing them under school, which means all of them, they were under school. Then 2013 there, I made a solar radio, which was using solar energy as a source of power. Some radios interviews and other newspaper interviews, they interviewed me about that. Then on 2015 there, I made an electric train which was using down electricity, and some television like Urban TV, they interviewed me about that with a show radio which was using, which it was a show at the same time, it was a radio. 2015-2016, I made a cell phone charger where people were using electricity at first to charge the phones and the solar energy, which was not good for the country. I made a cell phone charger in order to keep the smartphones on and to extend the power into local villages where there is no electricity. That project went through 2015, where even I reached the extent of exhibiting the President of Uganda, His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni. The same year, I did exhibition to the Inspector General of Police, that is Kale Kihura, where he liked the idea and he was promising me those things, but the President promised me those things. But Ugandans, they have been blocking my lines in terms of my support.
Twine Julius envisions himself becoming one of the greatest minds remembered globally, following in the fields of the world's great minds in science. Bill Gates, the co-founder of Microsoft, and the man who made the world's first light bulb, Thomas Edison.
I have been with kind of mind like to get the big population, like the person who came up with the idea of computers, Bill Gates, make the world under me, to get my name in the world. And I do these things, especially Ugandans, we have been far buying things from outside. So I have been with kind of that spirit of saying, let us make our things, but not needing for other countries, everything. As they have been telling us that Uganda is like a supermarket where everything, they are there, we just buy. So I have been with that kind of mind of buying things, doing things on our own, and we make these things. Although I have not yet reached on market and company, but that's where I'm heading, in market and factory processing, if I get chance of support and investors. So all of my prototypes are working, but I have not yet reached that level of of product, because the many Ugandans, they have been corriding me in my support, like of the exhibition of the president. President liked my idea and he was able to support me. But the people broke my lines to get my support. Up to now, I have not yet got my
Which
support.
Idea is that?
It was a cellphone charger, the stroke self-power generation. Yeah, that was 2016. Plus even Inspector General Police, he did some kind of support. Those support would be leading me to the products making, but I can't get that thing very well.
With dreams of going back to school, he appeals for more support to further his innovation and dreams. Julius tells us what drove his inspiration to make the TJ17 energy saver.
TJ17 Beraco energy saver, that is the bulb. In Uganda, we have been with a problem where electricity goes off and many people run for candles. People run for buying paraffins and other sources of buying fuel for generators. At the end of the day, they end up losing millions and millions of money, like candle burning houses. We have been seeing things in newspapers, air news, that the houses they are burned on with candles. So I have tried to solve that problem of Ugandans, and now Ugandans in expenses in electricity, they are very high, especially in companies, schools and other companies, hospitals, where they use a lot of bills to buy electricity. I tried to make that TJ17 Beraco energy saver. All the energy savers that we have in Uganda, there is no energy saver where the power goes off and we remain in light for some 9 hours or 2 days. But with my energy saver, Beraco energy saver, it will be able to give you light for 2 days or 1.5 days, that is 48 hours. Light when the power goes off, and the expected time of off of electricity is almost between 1 hour, 1 day. So you will be able to remain in light, no need of running for candles, no need of to run for other things which will take human life. My target audience mostly in towns, streets and hospitals, those all big companies, and even in rural areas where they can't afford buying much electricity. Because like in town, where you find that you have been buying electricity of 20,000, you will find that with my TJ Beraco energy saver, you will be buying energy like bill of 5,000 in a month.
Uganda is slowly striding in advancing technological and innovation capabilities, ranking low in technological innovation, human capital, and other measures of economic competitiveness. Uganda also for a long period of time has relied on imported products. Therefore, such innovations from young minds bring the country to a more competitive place in the world market.
Well, I think Uganda has enormous potential in innovation. And what has been lacking is the attention we've been giving to innovation. Luckily, that is changing. It has changed. So we now have initiatives within the Ministry of ICT and National Guidance that are there to support these innovations. The other important ingredient was the standardization of innovations that the young innovators put onto the market. That is also being addressed. We have the National IT Authority with a whole list of standards that we shall follow to ensure that the products that these people put out in the market can be consumed by first we as government and then the public, and where possible, export those innovations.
Government has allocated over 15 billion Uganda shillings into boosting innovations among the young minds, as 80 of the country's population is the youth, something that has seen the likes of Julius Twine benefit.